let's consider this rocket sled and see if we can figure out how much force each one of these rockets has to exert in order to accelerate our sled. So the sled's initial acceleration is 49 meters per second squared, and the mass of our system is 2,100 kilograms. The force of friction that's opposing our motion here is 650 newtons. So we want to know how much thrust does each of these four rockets have to exert for this to be true. We'll start by listing some things we know: my acceleration, my mass, my force of friction, and then I'll draw a free body diagram. And I know you might think, hey, look, this looks like a free body diagram already. Right, fine, but let's go ahead and draw our own just to make sure we know how to do this. So here's our free body diagram. What we have is we have our normal force acting up. That's our normal force from the track that's keeping us from falling through the track. We have the weight of the rocket sled acting downward. And those hopefully balance each other and we don't have to worry about them. That's in the y direction. Hopefully we don't have to worry about that. And then we have the thrust from the rocket. So we have four thrusts acting to the right and friction acting to the left. Here I've drawn my little rocket and I've defined my coordinate system with my x and the y there. We know it's accelerating to the right. Now, with that free body diagram, we can now write Newton's second law. And the part we care about here is the x component. So this is my vector expression, sums of the forces are equal to mass times acceleration, and this will be true in the x direction and in the y direction. But we mostly care about the x direction here. Let's consider the y direction just to see. If we sum the forces in the y direction, we're not accelerating up or down, it's staying on the track. So that y becomes zero. And we can say that my normal force minus my weight is equal to zero, so my normal force is equal to the weight of the rocket sled. This is not always true, but this is true in this case. Lovely. Doesn't really do much for me. What I want to know is the thrust. So for that, we're going to use the x direction. Sums of the forces in the x are equal to mass times acceleration in the x. We can now include the forces that are actually acting from my free body diagram. So anything acting to the right will be positive here on the left. Anything acting to the left will be negative. So this gives us 4t minus f is equal to mass times acceleration in the f, in the x. We want to know what our thrust is, so we'll do a little bit of algebra and add this force of friction to both sides, and then divide the result by 4 to get my thrust equaling mass times acceleration plus the force of friction divided by 4. We can plug in the things we know from over here and evaluate that, and we should get that the thrust from each rocket has to be 2.5 times 10 to the fourth newtons. To recap what we did, we started with understanding what the problem was asking for, writing down some things we knew, drawing a free body diagram, and then using that free body diagram to write our Newton's second law expressions in the x and the y directions, and solving for the thing that we wanted to know from there.